Hello everyone and welcome to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. My name is Francesco D'Alessio and welcome back to another video. So in today's video, what we're going to be doing is doing a sort of workshop feature. This isn't a regular video that we do. Inbox Zero is a topic that I've not really talked about here on the channel. I've sort of dumped it in a few places, like when I talk about general productivity advice and things like that. I think that the email inbox is sometimes a source of a lot of pain for a lot of people out there. So I know that many people in the comments always put, the email inbox is killing me. And what I want to do today is share a few processes that I've picked up from the likes of Merlin Mann in his process Inbox Zero, GTD, David Allen's techniques, and applying them to inbox. And also just taking and cherry picking stuff from other people that I have found works in the past. So I'm going to be sharing you my live inbox and going through and clearing my email. So I'll be doing it around about the time, probably 5 o'clock today. So hopefully it will be a nice interactive session. Shouldn't take more than 15 minutes. So hopefully it will be good for you to watch and enjoy. Just before we jump in, a note from me, I will be using Newton Mail, which is my email of choice. I also work with Newton on the marketing team. But that's pretty much because I fell in love with the resource. I'll include the link in the description, but again, I might be biased to the experience, but I'll mainly be focusing on the processes and technique. Anyway guys, without further ado, let's jump over to the laptop and enjoy this session. Hey everyone, welcome back to the feature. This is going to be my email inbox focus. Now, as I was mentioning before, I will be using Newton for this feature, so I will include a link in the description, but it's totally up to you to what you use, but some of the features that I'll be mentioning will be specific to Newton, but some applications are able to replicate it, but I just wanted to make you aware of that before we get started. Now, 99% of the time, I start the inbox at the bottom, mainly because I find it a pretty effective way to start from the bottom and reach the top. Now, one of the things that I tend to do when I get started is I tend to clear out some of the ones I know aren't necessarily emails I need to reply to. So in this case, I can see a few newsletter-based emails that have worked their way in here. I'm going to click and hover on these. I'm going to delete some of the ones that I know have bounced back from certain other replies. As you can see, I've selected like 5 at the moment. I can't see any more from here yet that I'm going to get rid of. So I'm just going to simply archive them. So that's 7 archived, and that just makes the inbox look a little sort of more smaller. So that's how I get rid of the main sort of bulk of email when I get started with, because when I come across them, it just is a waste of time. Now, here's an email from Axel. So this is something that Axel, I'm actually going to be reviewing in about 2 weeks. And I know I'm going to come back to this one actually, because Axel's been ever so kind and reviewed and actually been able to translate one of my videos into French. And he's done that off his own back, which is very kind. So I'm just going to pop this one actually into my read section. And I have a read section, which is basically reference inside of all of my inboxes. I have 3 actually. I have actions, I have waiting, and I have the ability to put it in read. So I'm going to put it in read for now. Again, this one is one that I will be chasing up at the time. So it's reference, so I'm going to put it in read. These are work-based items, so I hate that I'm blowing all of this out, guys, but it's important that this goes. So this one actually is something that I need to get to quite importantly. So I actually probably need to do this one a little later today. So I'm going to delay it or snooze it until you can see down here at 7:18. So that will pop up a little later. Now, this one was actually reference based on some of the new languages we're launching. This one here is Diogo, who I'm in conversation with, who we were chatting this morning. So he was wanted some feedback or some stuff. So I'm going to snooze this one tomorrow so I can fully reply to it. Another contract that I need to sign, so I'm going to do it later this evening. Okay, so this one is actually probably one that I need to reply to. So my rule with email is that if I can do it in 2 minutes or less, then I will do it. and that's whether it's an action or a reply. So here, Carl, Scott, and I are trying to plan a certain date to get a three-way call done. So Carl's saying, I can let you guys know my availability for that week on the 11th, on the Wednesday. So we need to chat nearer the time. So I'm actually going to snooze this one until Sunday, which will pop up then. And the next one is just some information about work. So we'll be able to Teachable, have an email for them through Teachable. So we'll get in touch with you. So that's for them to get in touch with me. So another one from Alice, who's in the community, and I already gave her all of the information. So this one's a reference. So most of my emails, as you can see, are going in read. And as you can see, I'm clearing this inbox pretty slowly. Now, this one's quite important to me. So right now, I'm actually going to snooze this one till later because I want this one to pop up later. Now, if I go down to the bottom, I've got an email from Enric who actually message me and actually wanted some more information. So I'm actually going to reply to this one pretty much after this. So I'm going to pause that one and keep it at the bottom of my inbox. Another one that is reference, but I've got actually a question inside of here. So I'm guessing this is going to take 2 minutes. How, I'm going to drop me an email by the time we can discuss them in a minute. Okay, yep, sure. I'm going to reply to this one and just say, sure thing. Let me know when you have that. And I'm going to send it. So I'm also going to read that one. And then obviously, of course, that one is a reference and it will jump me back to the previous one. Now we've got an app review inquiry. So I'm actually going to keep that one for Sunday. I tend to just keep any items for Sunday there. Again, this one's another wedding admin one. So I'm going to delay this one until Wednesday because I know that's a conversation that me and Beck are going to have on Wednesday. I have a one here that I'm organizing my stag do because I'm getting married in the summertime. So what I'm going to do with this one actually is reply to it because I need to confirm a time. So I'm going to say, let's do 1 p.m. if they can. And what is the deposit amount? Because I actually need to know how much this is going to be. We're going go-karting. Which is pretty fun. So what is the deposit deposit amount? Oop. And I'm going to send that one off. So that one's a really, actually, I probably need to follow up to that one because I'm going to click that one on Wednesday so that I can just healthily follow up. Now, I can scroll through these emails right to left, so I might just do that. So I've actually done that piece of work for today. I've actually got these two on reference because I'm both in. So again, that goes in read because that's a reference that I need for later. Now, I actually wasn't able to find that mailbox, so I'm going to delete it. If I had the reason to chase it up, then I would. I've got another one here, so I'm going to tomorrow morning. As you can see, I'm snoozing a lot of these emails, and that's mainly because I'm either putting them in snooze or I'm actually putting them in read later. Because most of them are static. Most of them are ones that I don't need to action. Now, if I were to action, and I actually probably do need to action a few of these top ones here. So this one actually is another read one. So I'll pop it in read. Let's say I wanted this one. So I actually need to chase up on US shipment. And I'm actually going to put a P1 to it. And it goes straight to my inbox, ready for me to chase up. And I'm going to put it in read for later. But a lot of the time I would put it in action, so it's sort of ready. But again, it's a reference one, so it's very helpful that it's going there. So I still use folders pretty much all the time. Now, this one's got a bunch of actions in the center, so I'm actually going to copy and paste that one into my to-do's tab and send that one off. And then I'm actually going to reply and actually say, that looks all great. Thanks. And send over. And then I'm going to put it in my read. Okay, so this one's another App Store report thing, so I'm actually going to clear it. And I'm left finally with one that I actually need to focus and reply to. So what I've recently been doing as well is to a lot of emails is actually do this thing here. So I'm going to go reply all, and I'm going to go up the cloud app, and I'm going to click record webcam video. And as you can see, it will pop up. And I'm actually going to record a reply, but I won't do it now. We'll just do it in a sec. I'm actually going to record a reply to this one because it's actually faster for me. sometimes to do that. So I'm actually going to record a video reply. It's more personal sometimes, especially for someone who's replying on YouTube. But for now, I'm actually going to leave that one for later. So I'm going to use that snooze function and put it for later. And that's tend to how I get to inbox zero most of the time. As I go throughout my day, I tend to just send emails versus I either reply or send emails directly to people. And then I do a batch between 7 or 8 a.m. In the morning, which is like my big clear out before the day starts. And then I have a separate batch, which is between 4 p.m. and 5 p.m., 4:30 now. So I did that one in round about, I'm going to say 8 minutes properly. But you might have a better time because I actually didn't have I didn't actually start timing that one. But it's just a good way to clear out all of that good stuff. Now I'm going to make sure I haven't missed anything here. But my goal tends to be a lot of time to get to zero, which is quite important. I read the, I actually didn't actually read that. I watched a lot of Merlin Mann theories on processing. I used to do per inbox processing. So I would go over here, open this section up and actually clear an inbox out per count, which was quite a helpful process, but at the time it just got pretty messy. I don't know why, I just do the all inbox now. I think it depends on the sort of process you go through. And then if I go here, I've got the action read waiting set up, which is quite nice. So I can actually quickly save stuff to different sections. So guys, that was an inbox zero processing for me, a regular everyday one. Now, I didn't want to give too much detail here, so a lot of it was blurred out, but I gave you a bit of context to what I was doing. Let me know in the comments whether this was helpful. I'm not sure whether it was too helpful, but again, it gives me some feedback to whether I'm going to probably do this in the future. So do let me know in the comments how you found this, whether it actually affected your inbox and whether you go away and do stuff. But my general rule is probably sort of GTD rule is if it needs replying or can get done in 2 minutes or less, then I'll do it on the spot. If it doesn't, I'll tend to snooze it or base it around an admin period that I do during my day. So guys, I hope that one was useful. Let me know in the comments below if you have any questions and I'll happily answer them. Anyway guys, make sure to have a great day, keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.